Indian Constitution, Part 1, The Union and Its Territory, Articles 1, Name and Territory of the Union, 2, Admission or Establishment of New States, 2A, Repealed, 3, Formation of New States and Alteration of Areas, Boundaries, or Names of Existing States. 4. Laws made under Articles 2 and 3 to provide for the amendment of the 1st and 4th Schedules and Supplemental, Incidental, and Consequential Matters. Part 2. Citizenship. Article 5. Citizenship at the commencement of the Constitution. 6. Rights of citizenship of certain persons who have migrated to India from Pakistan. 7. Rights of citizenship of certain migrants of Pakistan. 8. Rights of citizenship of certain persons of Indian origin residing outside India. 9. Persons voluntarily acquiring citizenship of a foreign state not to be citizens. 10. Continuance of the rights of citizenship. 11. Parliament to regulate the rights of citizenship by law. Part 3. Fundamental Rights. Article 12. Definition. 13. Laws inconsistent with or in derogation of the fundamental rights. Right to equality. Article 14. Equality before law. 15. Prohibition of discrimination on grounds of religion, race, caste, sex, or place of birth. 16. Equality of opportunity in matters of public employment. 17. Abolition of untouchability. 18. Abolition of titles. Right to freedom. Article 19. Protection of certain rights regarding freedom of speech, etc. 20. Protection in respect of conviction for offences. 21. Protection of life and personal liberty. 21A. Right to education. 22. Protection against arrest and detention in certain cases. Next topic, right against exploitation. 23. Article 23. Prohibition of traffic in human beings and forced labor. 24. Prohibition of employment of children in factories, etc. Next topic, right to freedom of religion. 25. Article, freedom of conscience and free profession, practice and propagation of religion. 26. Freedom to manage religious affairs. 27. Freedom as to payment of taxes for promotion of any particular religion. 28. Freedom as to attendance at religious instruction or religious worship in certain educational institutions. Next topic, cultural and educational rights. 29. Protection of interest of minorities. 30. Right of minorities to establish and administer educational institutions. 31. Repealed. Next topic, saving of certain laws. 31A. Saving of laws providing for acquisition of estates, etc. 31B. Validation of certain acts and regulations. 31C. Saving of laws giving effect to certain directive principles. 31D. Repealed. Next topic, right to constitutional remedies. 32. Remedies for enforcement of rights conferred by this part. 32A. Repealed. 33. Power of Parliament to modify the rights conferred by the part in their application to forces, etc. 34. Restriction on rights conferred by this part while martial law is in force in any area. 35. Legislation to give effect to the provisions of this part. Part 5. Directive principles of state policy. 36. Definition. 37. Application of the principles contained in this part. 37. 38. State to secure a social order of the promotion of welfare of the people. 39. Certain principles of policy to be followed by the state. 39A. Equal justice and free legal aid. 40. Organization of village panchayats. 41. Right to work, to education and to public assistance in certain cases. 42. Provision for just and humane conditions of work and maternity relief. 43. Living wage, etc. for workers. 43A. Participation of workers in management of industries. 44. Uniform civil code for the citizens. 45. Provision for early childhood care and education to children below the age of 6 years. 46. Promotion of educational and economic interest of scheduled caste, scheduled tribes and other weaker sections. 47. Duty of the state to raise the level of nutrition and the standard of living and to improve public health. 48. Organization of agriculture and animal husbandry. 48A. Protection and improvement of environment and safeguarding of forest and wildlife. 50. Separation of judiciary from executive. 51. Promotion of international peace and security. Part 4A. Fundamental duties. 51A. Fundamental duties. Part 5. The Union. Under this, Chapter 1. The Executive. The President and Vice President. 52. The President of India. 53. Executive power of the Union. 54. Election of President. 55. Manner of election of President. 56. Term of office of President. 57. Eligibility for re-election. 58. Qualifications for election as President. 59. Conditions of President's office. 60. Oath and affirmation by the President. 61. Procedure for impeachment of the President. 62. Time of holding election to fill vacancy in the office of President and the term of office of person elected to fill casual vacancy. 63. The Vice President of India. 64. The Vice President to be ex officio chairman of the Council of States. 65. The Vice President to act as President or to discharge his functions during casual vacancies in the office or during the absence of President. 66. Election of Vice President. 67. Term of office of Vice President. 68. Time of holding election to fill vacancy in the office of Vice President and the term of office of person elected to fill casual vacancy. 69. Oath or affirmation by the Vice President. 70. Discharge of President's functions in other contingencies. 71. Matters relating to or connected with the election of a President or Vice President. 72. Power of President to grant pardons, etc. and to suspend, remit or commute sentences in certain cases. 73. Extent of executive power of the Union, Council of Ministers. 74. Council of Ministers to aid and advise President. 75. Other provisions as to ministers. 76. Attorney General of Attorney General for India. 77. Conduct of business of the Government of India. 78. Duties of Prime Minister as respects the furnishing of information to the President, etc. Chapter 2. Parliament. General. 79. Constitution of Parliament. 80. Composition of the Council of States. 81. Composition of the House of the People. 82. Readjustment after each census. 83. Duration of Houses of Parliament. 84. Qualification for membership of Parliament. 85. Sessions of Parliament. Prorogation and dissolution. 86. Rights of President to address and send messages to houses. 87. Special address by the President. 88. Rights of ministers and attorney general as respects houses. Offices of the Parliament. Article 89. The chairman and deputy chairman of the Council of States. 90. Vacation and resignation of and removal from the office of deputy chairman. 91. Power of the deputy chairman or other person to perform the duties of the office of or to act as chairman. 92. The chairman or the deputy chairman not to be preside while a resolution for his removal from office is under consideration. 93. The speaker and deputy speaker of the House of the People. 94. Vacation and resignation of and removal from the offices of speaker and deputy speaker. 95. Power of the deputy speaker or other persons to perform the duties of the office of or to act as speaker. 96. The speaker or the deputy speaker not to preside while a resolution for his removal from the office is under consideration. 97. Salaries and allowances of chairman and deputy chairman and the speaker and deputy speaker. 98. Secretariat of Parliament. 99. Oath or affirmation by members. 100. Voting in houses, power of houses to act, notwithstanding vacancies and quorum. 101. Vacation of seats. 102. Disqualifications for membership. 103. Decision on questions as to disqualifications of members. 104. Penalty for sitting and voting before making oath or affirmation under Articles 99 or when not qualified or when disqualified. 105. Powers, privileges, etc. on the Houses of Parliament and of the members and committees thereof. 106. Salaries and allowances of members. 107. Provisions as to introduction and passing of bills. 108. Joint sitting of the both houses in certain cases. 109. Special procedure in respect of money bills. 110. Definition of money bills. 111. Assent to bills. Procedure in financial matters. Article 112, Annual Financial Statement. 113, Procedure in Parliament with respect to estimates. 114, Appropriation Bills. 115, Supplementary, Additional or Excess Grants. 116, Votes on Account, Votes of Credit and Exceptional Grants. 117, Special Provisions as to Financial Bills. 118, Rules of Procedure. 119. Regulation by Law of Procedure in Parliament in relation to financial business. 120. Language to be used in Parliament. 121. Restriction on discussion in Parliament. 122. Courts not to inquire into proceedings of Parliament. Chapter 3. Legislative Powers of the President. Article 123. Power of President to promulgate ordinance during recess of Parliament. 123. I am repeating. Power of President to promulgate ordinances during recess of Parliament. Chapter 4. The Union Judiciary. 124 Establishment and Constitution of Supreme Court. 125 Salaries, etc. of Judges. 126 Appointment of Acting Chief Justice. 127 Appointment of Ad hoc Judges. 128 Attendance of Retired Judges at Sittings of the Supreme Court. 129 Supreme Court to be a court of record. 130 Seat of a Supreme Court. 131 Original Jurisdiction of the Supreme Court. 131A Repealed. 132 Appellate Jurisdiction of Supreme Court in appeals from high courts in certain cases. 133 Appellate Jurisdiction of Supreme Court in appeals from high courts in regard to civil matters. 134 Appellate Jurisdiction of Supreme Court in regard to criminal matters. 134A Certificate of Appeal to the Supreme Court. 135 Jurisdiction and powers of the Federal Court under existing law to be exercisable by the Supreme Court. 136 Special leave to appeal by the Supreme Court. 137 Review of judgment or orders by the Supreme Court. 138 Enlargement of the jurisdiction of the Supreme Court. 139 Conferment on the Supreme Court of powers to issue certain writs. 139A Transfer of certain cases. 140 Ancillary powers of Supreme Court. 141 Law declared by Supreme Court to be binding on all courts. 142 Enforcement of decrees and orders of Supreme Court and orders as to discovery, etc. 143 Power of President to consult Supreme Court. 144 Civil and judicial authorities to act in aid of the Supreme Court. 144A repealed. 145 Rules of Court, etc. 146 Officers and servants and the expenses of the Supreme Court. 147 Interpretation. Chapter 5 Controller and Auditor Controller of India. 148 Comptroller and Auditor General of India. 149 Duties and powers of the Comptroller and Auditor General. 150 Form of accounts of the Union and of the States. 151 Audit reports. Part 6 152 Definition. That's come under Chapter 1 General. 152 is Definition. Chapter 2 The Executive, the Governor. 153 Governors of States. 154 Executive powers of State. 155 Appointment of Governor. 156 Term of office of Governor. 157 Qualifications for appointment as Governor. 158 Conditions of Governor's office. 159 Oath or affirmation by the Governor. 160 Discharge of the functions of the Governor in certain contingencies. 161 Power of Governor to grant pardons, etc., and to suspend, remit, or commute sentences in certain cases. 162 Extent of executive powers of state. 163 Council of Ministers to aid and advise Governor. 164 Other provisions as to ministers. The Advocate General for the State. 165 Advocate General for the State. 166 Conduct of business of the government of a state. 167 Duties of a Chief Minister as respects the furnishing of information to Governor, etc. Chapter 3 The State Legislature. 168 Constitution of Legislature in States. 169 Abolition or setting of legislative councils in States. 170 Composition of the Legislative Assemblies. 171 Composition of the Legislative Councils. 172 Duration of State Legislature. 173 Qualification for Membership of the State Legislature. 174 Sessions of the State Legislature. Prorogation and Dissolution. 175, right of governor to address and send messages to the house or houses. 176, special address by the governor. 177, rights of ministers and advocate general as respects the houses. 178, the speaker and deputy speaker of the legislative assembly. 179, vacation and resignation of and removal from the officers or speaker and deputy speaker. 180, power of the deputy speaker or other person to perform the duties of the office of or to act as speaker. 181, the speaker or the deputy speaker not to preside while a resolution for his removal from office is under consideration. 182, the chairman and deputy chairman of the legislative council. 183, vacation and resignation of and removal from the offices of chairman and deputy chairman. 184, power of deputy chairman or other person to perform the duties of the office of or to act as chairman. 185, the chairman or the deputy chairman not to preside while a resolution for his removal from office is under consideration. 186, salaries and allowances of the speaker and deputy speaker and the chairman and deputy chairman. 187, secretariat of state legislature. 188, oath or affirmation by members. 189, voting in houses, power of houses to act, notwithstanding vacancies and quorum. 190, vacation of seats. 191, disqualifications for membership. 192, decision on questions as to disqualifications of members. 193, penalty for sitting and voting before making oath or affirmation under Article 188 or when not qualified or when disqualified. 194, powers, privileges, etc. of the Houses of Legislature and of the members and committees thereof. 195, salaries and allowances of members. 196, provisions as to introduction and passing of bills. 197, restriction on powers of Legislative Council as to bills other than money bills. 198, special procedure in respect of money bills. 199, definition of money bills. 200, assent to bills. 201, bills reserved for consideration. 202, annual financial statement. 203, procedure in legislature with respect to estimates. 204, appropriation bills. 205, supplementary, additional or excess grants. 206, votes on account, votes of credit and exceptional grants. 207, special provision as to financial bills. 208, rules of procedure. 209, regulation by law of procedure in legislature of the state in relation to financial business. 210, language to be used in the legislature. 211, restriction on discussion in the legislature. 212, courts not to inquire into proceedings of the legislature. 213, power of governor to promulgate ordinances during recess of legislature. Chapter 5, the High Courts in the States. 214, High Courts of the States. 215, High Courts to be Courts of Record. 216, Constitution of High Courts. 217, Appointment of Conditions of the Office of a Judge of a High Court. 218, Application of Certain Provisions Relation. 218, Application of Certain Provisions Relating to the Supreme Court to High Courts. 219, Oath or Affirmation by Judges of High Courts. 220, Restriction on Practice After Being a Permanent Judge. 221, Salaries, etc. of Judges. 222, Transfer of a Judge from one High Court to another. 223, Appointment of Acting Chief Justice. 224, A, Appointment of Additional and Acting Judges. 224A, Appointment of Retired Judges at Sitting of High Courts. 225, jurisdiction of existing high courts. 226, power of high courts to issue certain writs. 226A, repealed. 227, power of superintendence over all courts by the High Court. 228, transfer of certain cases to High Court. 228A, repealed. 229, offices and servants and other expenses of High Courts. 230, extension of jurisdiction of High Courts to Union Territories. 231, establishment of a common High Court for two or more states. Chapter 6, subordinate courts. 233, appointment of district judges. 233A, validation of appointments of and judges, validation of appointments of and judgments, etc., delivered by certain district judges. 234, recruitment of persons other than district judges to the judicial service. 235, control over subordinate courts. 236, interpretation. 237, application of the provisions of this chapter to certain class or class of magistrate. Part 7, the states in Part B of the first schedule. 238, repealed. Part 8, the Union Territories. 239, administration of Union Territories. 239A, creation of local legislature or council of ministers or both for certain Union Territories. 239A, special provisions with respect to Delhi. 239AA, provision in case of failure of constitutional machinery. 239AB, power of administrator to promulgate ordinances during recess of legislature. 240, power of president to make regulations for certain Union Territories. 241, high courts for Union Territories. 242, repealed. Chapter 9, the panchayats. 243, definitions. 243A, Gram Sabha. 243B, constitution of panchayats. 243C, composition of panchayats. 243D, reservation of seats. 243E, duration of panchayats, etc. 243F, disqualifications for membership. 243G, powers, authority and responsibilities of panchayats. 243H, powers to impose taxes by and funds of the panchayats. 243I, constitution of finance commission to review financial position. 243J, audit of accounts of panchayats. 243K, elections to the panchayats. 243L, application to Union Territories. 243M, part not to apply to certain areas. 243N, continuance of existing laws and panchayats. 243O, bar to interference by courts in electoral matters. Part 9A, the municipalities. 243P, definitions. 243Q, constitution of municipalities. 243R, composition of municipalities. 243S, constitution and composition of wards, committees, etc. 243T, reservation of seats. 243U, duration of municipalities, etc. 243V, disqualifications for membership. 243W, powers, authority and responsibilities of municipalities, etc. 243X, power to impose taxes by and funds of the municipalities. 243Y, finance commission. 243Z, audit of accounts of municipalities. 243ZA, election to the municipalities. 243ZB, application to Union Territories. 243ZC, part not to apply to certain areas. 243ZD, committee for district planning. 243ZE, committee for metropolitan planning. 243ZF, continuance of existing laws and municipalities. 243ZG, bar to interference by courts in electoral matters. Part 10, the scheduled and tribal areas. 244, article 244, Administration of Scheduled Areas and Tribal Areas, 244A, Formation of an Autonomous State Comprising Certain Tribal Areas in Assam, and Creation of Local Legislature or Council of Ministers or both thereof. Part 11, Relations Between the Union and the States. Chapter 1, Legislative Relations, Distribution of Legislative Powers. 245, Extent of Laws Made by Parliament and by the Legislatures of the State. 246, Subject Matter of Laws Made by Parliament and by the Legislatures of the State. 247, Power of Parliament to Provide for the Establishment of Certain Additional Courts. 248, Residuary Powers of Legislation. 249, Power of Parliament to Legislate with Respect to Matters in the State List in the National Interest. 240, Power of Parliament to Legislate with Respect to Any Matters in the State List if a Proclamation of Emergency is in operation. 251, Inconsistency between laws made by the Parliament under Articles 249 and 250 and laws made by the Legislature of States. 252, Power of Parliament to legislate for two or more states by consent and adoption of much legislation by any other state. 253, Legislation for giving effect to international agreements. 254, Inconsistency between laws made by Parliament and laws made by the Legislature of States. 255, Requirements as to recommendations and previous sanctions to be regarded as matters of procedures only. Chapter 2. Chapter 2, Borrowing. 292, Borrowing by the Government of India. 293, Borrowing by States. Chapter 3, Property. 294, Succession to Property as Assets, Rights, Liabilities and Obligation in Certain Cases. 295, Succession to Property, Assets, Rights, Liabilities and Obligations in Other Cases. 296, Property Acquiring by Escheat or Lapse or as Bona Vacantia. 297, Things of Value within Territorial Waters or Continental Shelf and Resources of the Exclusive Economic Zone to Western the Union. 298, Power to Carry on Trade, etc. 299, Contracts. 300, Suits and Proceedings. Chapter 4, Right to Property. 300A, Persons not to be deprived of property save by authority of law. Part 13, Trade, Commerce and Intercourse within the Territory of the India. 301, Freedom of Trade, Commerce and Intercourse. 302, Powers of Parliament to Impose Restrictions on Trade, Commerce and Intercourse. 303, Restrictions on the Legislative Powers of Union and of the States with regard to Trade and Commerce. 304, Restrictions on Trade, Commerce and Intercourse among States. 305, Saving of Existing Laws and Laws Providing for State Monopolies. 306, Repeal. 307, Appointment of Authority for Carrying out the Purpose of Article 301 to 304. Chapter 14, Services Under the Union and the States. Chapter 1, Services. 308, Interpretation. 309, Recruitment and Conditions of Service of Persons Serving the Union or a State. 310, Tenure of Office of Persons Serving the Union or a State. 311, Dismissal, Removal or Reduction in Rank of Persons Employed in Civil Capacities Under the Union or State. 312, All India Services. 312A, Power of Parliament to Vary or Revoke Conditions of Service of Officers of Certain Services. 313, transactional provisions, 314 Revealed, Chapter 2, Public Service Commissions. 315, Article 315, Public Service Commissions for the Union and for the States. 316, Appointment and Term of Office of Members. 317, Removal and Suspension of a Member of a Public Service Commission. 318, Power to Make Regulations as to Conditions of Service of Members and Staff of the Commission. 319, Prohibition as to the Holding of Offices by Members of Commission on Ceasing to be Such Members. 320, Functions of Public Service Commissions. 321, Power to Extend Functions of Public Service Commissions. 322, Expenses of Public Service Commissions. 323, Reports of Public Service Commissions. Part 14A, Tribunals. 323A, Administrative Tribunals. 323B, Tribunals for Other Matters. Part 15, Elections. 324, Superintendent's Directions and Control of Elections to be vested in an Election Commission. 325, No person to be ineligible for inclusion in or to claim to be included in a special electoral roll on grounds of religion, race, caste or sex. 326, Election to the House of the People and to Legislative Assemblies of States to be on the basis of adult suffrage. 327, Power of Parliament to make provision with respect to elections to legislatures. 328, Power of Legislature of a State to make provision with respect to elections to such legislature. 329, Bar to interference by courts in electoral matters. 329A, Repealed. Part 16, Special Provisions Relating to Certain Classes. 330, Reservation of seats for Scheduled Caste and Scheduled Tribes in House of the People. 331, Representation of the Anglo-Indian Community in the House of the People. 332, Reservation of seats for Scheduled Caste and Scheduled Tribes in the Legislative Assemblies of the States. 333, Representation of the Anglo-Indian Community in the Legislative Assemblies of the States. 334, Reservation of seats and special representation to cease after 7 years. 335, Claims of Scheduled Caste and Scheduled Tribes to Services and Post. 336, Special Provision for Anglo-Indian Community in Certain Services. 337, Special Provision with respect to Educational Grants for the Benefit of Anglo-Indian Community. 338, National Commission for Scheduled Caste. 338A, National Commission for Scheduled Tribes. 339, Control of the Union over the Administration of Scheduled Areas and the Welfare of Scheduled Tribes. 340, Appointment of a Commission to Investigate the Conditions of the Backward Classes. 341, Scheduled Caste. 342, Scheduled Tribes. Part 17, Official Language. Chapter 1, Language of the Union. 343, Official Language of the Union. 344, Commission and Committee of Parliament on Official Language. Chapter 2, Regional Languages. Article 345, Official Language or Languages of a State. 346, Official Language for Communication between one state and another state or between a state and the Union. 347, Special Provision Relating to Language Spoken by a Section of the Population of a State. Chapter 3, Language of the Supreme Court, High Court, etc. Article 348, Language to be used in Supreme Court and in High Courts and for Acts, Bills, etc. 349, Special Procedure for Enactment of Certain Laws Relating to Language. Chapter 4, Special Directives. Article 350, Language to be used in representations for redress of grievances. 350A, Facilities for Instruction in mother tongue at primary stage. 350B, Special Officer for Linguistic Minorities. 351, Directive for Development of Hindi Language. Part 18, Emergency Provisions. So, Article 352, Proclamation of Emergency. 353, Effect of Proclamation of Emergency. 354, Application of Provisions Relating to Distribution of Revenues While a Proclamation of Emergency is in Operation. 355, Duty of Union to Protect State Against External Aggression and Internal Disturbance. 356, Provisions in Case of Failure of Constitutional Machinery in States. 357, Exercise of Legislative Powers under Proclamation issued under Article 356. 358, Suspension of Provisions of Article 19 during Emergencies. 359, Suspension of the Enforcement of the Rights Conferred by Part 3 during Emergencies. 359A, Repealed. 360, Provisions as to Financial Emergency. Part 19, Miscellaneous. Article 361, Protection of President and Governors and Raj Pramukhs. 361A, Protection of Publication of Proceedings of Parliament and State Legislatures. 361B, Disqualification for Appointment on Remunerative Political Post. 362, Removed. 363, Bar to Interference by Courts in Disputes Arising out of Certain Treaties, Agreements, etc. 363A, Recognition granted to rulers of Indian states to seize and privy possess to be abolished. 364, Special Provisions as to Major Ports and Aerodromes. 365, Effect of Failure to Comply with or to give effect to directions given by the Union. 366, Definitions. 367, Interpretation. Part 20, Amendment of Constitution. Article 368, Power of Parliament to Amend the Constitution and Procedure thereof. Part 21, Temporary, Transitional and Special Provisions. 369, Temporary power to Parliament to make laws with respect to certain matters in the state list as if they were matters in the concurrent list. 370. Temporary provisions with respect to the state of Jammu and Kashmir. 371. Special provision with respect to the state of Maharashtra and Gujarat. Article 370 has some amendments, so please refer to the latest news. Article 371, Special Provision with respect to the state of Nagaland. 371B, Special Provisions with respect to the state of Assam. 371C, Special Provision with respect to the state of Manipur. 371D, Special Provisions with respect to the state of Andhra Pradesh. 371E, Establishment of Central University in Andhra Pradesh. 371F, Special Provisions with respect to the state of Sikkim. 371G, Special Provision with respect to the state of Mizoram. 371H, Special Provision with respect to the state of Arunachal Pradesh. 371I, Special Provision with respect to the state of Goa. 372, Continuance in Force of Existing Laws and Their Adoption. 372A, Power of the President to Adopt Laws. 373, Power of President to Make Order in Respect of Persons under Preventive Detention in Certain Cases. 374, Provisions as to Judges of the Federal Court and Proceedings Pending in Federal Court or Before His Majesty in Council. 375, Courts, Authorities and Officers to Continue Functions Subject to the Provisions of the Constitution. 376, Provisions as to Judges of High Courts. 377. Provisions as to Comptroller and Auditor General of India, 378. Provisions as to Public Service Commissions, 378A. Special provision as to duration of Andhra Pradesh Legislative Assembly, 379 to 391 repealed, 392. Powers of the President to remove difficulties, Part 22. Short title commencement authoritative text in Hindi and repeals, 393. Short title, 394 commencement, 394A. Authoritative text in Hindi language, 395 repeals. So far these are all the numbered articles. These are the articles of Indian Constitution. So I request you all to subscribe to this channel and let us spread awareness about Indian Constitution, IPC codes and various acts which are useful to the students and public. So let us see about schedules. First schedule, 1. Chapter 1. The State, 2. The Union Territories. Second Schedule, Part A. Provisions as to the President and Governors of States. Part B. Repealed. Part C. Provisions as to the Speaker and Deputy Speaker of the Houses of the People and the Chairman and Deputy Chairman of the Council of States and the Speaker and the Deputy Speaker of the Legislative Assembly and the Chairman and the Deputy Chairman of the Legislative Council of a State. Part D. Provisions as to the judges of Supreme Court and High Courts. Part E. Provisions as to the Comptroller and Auditor General of India. Third Schedule. Forms of oaths or affirmations. Fourth Schedule. Allocation of seats in the Council of States. Fifth Schedule. Provisions as to the Administrative and Comptroller of Scheduled Area and Scheduled Tribes. Part A. General. Part B. Administration and Comptroller of Scheduled Areas and Scheduled Tribes. Part C. Scheduled Areas. Part D. Amendment of Schedule. Sixth Schedule. Provisions as to the Administration of Tribal Areas in the State of Assam, Meghalaya, Tripura and Mizoram. Seventh Schedule. List 1. Union List. List 2. State List. List 3. Concurrent List. 8th Schedule. Languages. 9th Schedule. Validation of certain acts and regulations. 10th Schedule. Provisions as to disqualification on ground of defection. 11th Schedule. Powers, authority and responsibilities of panchayats. 12th Schedule. Powers, authority and responsibilities of municipalities, etc. So these are all about the schedules. So thank you so much, my dear friends. Please do subscribe to this channel to know more about Indian Constitution or IPC codes or women's safety, or I am going to create an awareness on lot of topics in this YouTube channel. So please do subscribe, and this audio, this voice recording will be useful to lot of job aspirants who are preparing for civil services or any state government jobs. It is useful for most of the people, and also it will give a basic knowledge about Indian Constitution to each and everyone whoever listen to this audio clip. Thank you so much in advance, and go ahead and subscribe to this channel. Have a great day. Thank you.